Have you ever wondered how to add realistic colour to an image? Today, I'm going to share how I use double raw processing to go from this image to this image. Hello, I'm Robin Worley, welcome to LensCraft. When I posted this image to Instagram the other day, a few people commented on the soft light and the colours. In this video, I'll explain how to do this using a single RAW file processed twice. What we'll do is process the RAW file a first time to create a base image. We'll then process it a second time with different settings to create the colour for the sky. After that, we'll combine the two in Photoshop to produce a realistic effect. This technique's called double RAW processing, and it's often combined with luminosity masking. I'm starting with my image in Lightroom. I've previously applied adjustments to create a base image and I've saved those as a snapshot. If I apply the snapshot, you can see the difference it creates. These adjustments are aimed at reducing the image contrast so the dark shadows don't appear as dark and it gives the image a bit of a brighter and softer feel. I'll then open the image as a smart object in Photoshop. Now this is important because it preserves my ability to adjust the RAW file further. In Photoshop, you can see the icon on the image layer showing that this is the smart object. If I double-click the layer, it opens in Adobe Camera Raw, and you can see the changes that I made in Lightroom. The next step is to make a copy of the layer. It's important when you do this that you don't just make a copy. If you do that, any changes you make to one layer will show up in the other, which is what we don't want. We need to be able to adjust the smart objects independently of each other. To make the copy, right-click on the layer and select New Smart Object via Copy. Now I'm also going to rename the new layer to call it Sky Color, just to distinguish it. I can then double-click the new layer and open it in Adobe Camera Raw. To create the color effect for the sky, I'll just increase the temp slider, and I'll also increase the orange and yellow saturation using the HSL tool. Finally, I'll apply a split toning adjustment with yellow for the sky and blue for the shadows. The changes aren't very convincing at the moment, but it's just a starting point. Also remember, although I'm making changes to the colour, you can use this technique to blend almost any changes together. Now, when I hide the top layer, you can see the bottom layer is not affected by the changes I made. I can adjust the two layers independently. My next step is to add a layer mask to the top layer and invert it. This hides the layer's effect and means I can paint the colour into the image using a brush tool. I'll set the brush colour to be white. I'm also using a low hardness and opacity setting to help blend the two images. I can then brush the colour into the areas of the sky and water where I want it to appear. Now at first glance the result is okay, but it doesn't stand up to any scrutiny. I can improve this though by painting through a luminosity mask, and I'll just reset the layer mask to explain how. Whilst you can create luminosity masks manually, I'm going to be using an extension panel just for speed. There's a lot of these available including Raya Pro, Lumensia and Mask Equalizer. I'll include a list in the YouTube video information. I'll also include details of a video I published where I demonstrated a free luminosity masking panel you can use. For this example, I'll be using TK Actions to create a zone mask to work with. I can then refine this using a curve. What I'm trying to produce is a mask that selects the brighter areas of the sky, but not the mountains. I'll then use this to create a selection. Now I can paint onto the mask in the areas of the sky where I want the colour to appear. As I paint, I'm painting through the selection I created with the mask. You can't see the selection because the panel's hidden the marching ants when it created it. I'm sure you'll agree though, that by painting through a luminosity mask, I've created a much better result. And because these are two separate smart objects, I can continue to open and adjust each separately. Once you're happy, you can finish the adjustments of the image with the other effects you want to add. If you found this video useful, please let me know in the comments and please share it with others. I'm Robin Walley, you've been watching LensCraft, I'll see you next week for another video.